as the new criminal laws come into force today, the main opposition Congress saying these laws were forcibly passed by suspending 146 MPs from the parliament proceedings. The party also said that 90% of these laws are a cut, copy, paste job, while the others are completely unconstitutional. In fact, taking to the social media, ex-Congress President Mallikarjun Kharge said that Prime Minister Modi and the BJP seem to be pretending to value the constitution after an electoral and moral setback in the election. But the truth is that the new criminal laws that come into force today were passed forcibly by suspending 146 MPs. The India bloc will not allow this bulldozer law on parliamentary proceedings anymore. Let's go across to my colleague Shivani joining us on the broadcast. Shivani, just about 45 minutes to go for the parliament session to begin. The opposition had already raised the issue of NEET, the misuse of agencies in that long list prepared by the opposition. The criminal justice system also comes into place. The opposition saying that it had been passed in the parliament last December by bulldozing the opposition.
Pratibha, the opposition has added onto the list of its issues on which it is going to disrupt the parliament, it seems, because, you know, we've seen that last whole week the parliament could not function on the issue of NEET, and they hurriedly wanted to discuss the NEET issue. But now, even after the government has been assuring them that after the discussion takes place on the president's address, motion of thanks, and then they will be taking up the NEET issue, now they have new issues, and this happens to be the criminal laws, the new criminal laws that come into effect from today. 1st of July. And Manish Tiwari, as we were listening to him while he was talking to Times Network, he said that these laws are unconstitutional. They are hurriedly brought out laws. They should be discussed first in the parliament, joint sessions of the parliament, and then it should be implemented. While the government had its own stake, they say that they've been working on it for years, not only the government, but the stakeholders, the universities, the lawyers. Everybody has been going through special training sessions for the implementation of these new laws, and they are required for a speedy justice to the people of the country. That's what they say. Not only this, Pratibha, the Chief Justice of India has already said that these laws are very much required for a day-to-day conduct of a civilized society like India. So these laws, which have been researched upon, as the government goes on to say, the opposition says that these laws have been brought in haste. They need to be discussed. They need to be deferred. Mamata Banerjee has also said this. Aam Aadmi Party Saurabh Bharadwaj is also saying that these laws will confuse people, because for so many years people have been following the Indian Penal Code, the CRPC, and the prior laws, and yes, now these laws will take years to get handy with the people of the country. So these are the statements that are coming in from the opposition, and opposition seems to be in all mood to bring about this issue also.
Opposition saying time and again that people will take time to get accustomed to it, that these laws were brought in without taking into consideration what the opposition is saying. Shivani, since you mentioned the opposition, let's also go across to Meenakshi, who is joining us with the reactions that have been coming in from the opposition leaders on the day that these laws come into effect.
Well, yes, Pratibha, we have the reaction of Mallikarjun Kharge, P. Chidambaram, many other opposition leaders. I'm going to take you through the two biggest reactions which have come till now on social media. So this is Mallikarjun Kharge, Congress president, which you were just talking about. Very quickly, I'll tell you, Mallikarjun Kharge basically attacking the government over the new criminal justice system and the three new laws, saying that it's after political and moral shock in the elections, the BJP is quote-unquote pretending to respect the constitution. And then Mallikarjun Kharge says that the three laws of criminal justice system are being implemented today. They were forcibly passed by suspending 146 MPs. Chidambaram also says a very similar thing. He says that 90 to 99% of these quote-unquote so-called new laws are a cut, copy and paste job. He says that the task that could have been completed with a few amendments to existing three laws has been turned into a wasteful exercise. So these are the two big reactions which have come on this entire slugfest. Back to you, Pratibha.
Okay, all right. So the opposition leaders are raising an objection to it. And today in the parliament as well, we are expecting discussions. And of course, the opposition raising the issue time and again. The opposition leaders have already taken to social media to say that these laws are unjustified. They are going to be against common man. The common man is also going to find it difficult to understand the laws. Several issues that have been raised by the opposition leaders. Several of the opposition leaders, and remember the opposition bloc has been completely united over the same. Not just the Congress party, SP leaders also said that this new law that's going to be brought in, all the laws are completely unconstitutional. Listen in.